Welcome back to Smith Coating and Design. So what I have here is my anodizing setup. So I'm going to attempt to anodize some aluminum. I'm going to start with the lid to the coolant manifold that we saw in the previous videos. So let's just sort of walk through it here. So what I have is some degreaser. So first I will clean and degrease the part. I'll rinse it. We'll then go into our sulfuric acid bath. And what I have here is an inline fan that will exhaust any fumes outside of my window. I will be using aluminum for the cathode. So we have that here. I will be hanging my part, you know, with titanium wire. I did make a jig that will sort of sit on top of the 5-gallon bucket. So here we go. And then I will go ahead and hang my part from titanium wire using that jig. You notice that the acid bath is inside of a tote. And so that I did that so I could fill the tote with water and then potentially put ice packs in here if I run into cooling issues. I'm using this nice power supply I got from Amazon. I believe it's 30 amps. I will be using the low current density method from Caswell as a starting point, so we'll see how that goes. So anyway, we degrease, we rinse, we go into the acid. From there, we're going into a neutralizing bath, so that's just baking soda and water. We're going to rinse again, and then over here, I have a bucket of black dye from Caswell. I'm going to use this immersion heater to heat it up to the proper temperature. I believe this one has a built-in thermostat, so it should get me to where I need to be. And then from there, we'll dunk in the part, dye it, and then after that, I will go ahead and seal the part in some boiling water, and we'll just see how that turns out. Again, this is my first time anodizing. I guess the last thing I did want to cover is for agitation. I am going to use this wave generator. Let me show you this. So it's a wave generator instead of an aquarium pump. I didn't want to blow bubbles into the acid bath just because I didn't want there to be a lot of fumes or anything like that floating around the shop. So again, this particular wave generator, I mean, it's basically just a motor on an impeller, sort of, you know, just circulates the water. It worked well in my testing with just the distilled water. This particular version, there we go, it focused. It does have a plastic impeller and supposedly a ceramic shaft that is corrosion resistant. So hopefully this will work in the acid and won't dissolve on me or cause any problems. So that's my going in position, using this for agitation and, you know, using a piece of 6061 aluminum for my cathode. So hopefully that works out. I'll check back in with everybody once it's finished. All right, another update here. So we are about 1 hour in. Let's see if I pull this out. You can see there is a nice dull coloration there. So I think there is a good layer of oxide on the part. I'll just gently lower that back down. Try not to touch the cathode there. Sorry, it's hard to do with my phone. So anyway, I think we're good. I'm gonna go ahead and get the dye ready. Looking back at the Caswell calculator, I actually need to leave it in for 2 hours. I am aiming for a 1 mil thickness. Originally I had 0.5 mil in the calculator, which was 1 hour. So I need to leave this for 2 hours. So it's gonna be in there just a little longer, and then it's going to go into the dye, fingers crossed, and hope it turns out well. All right, so here the lid is after anodization. After I've anodized it, here's what the, I put this here to contrast the finish. So this would have been what the part looked like before being anodized. And this is the nice satin sheen after being anodized. I do have, pick this up here. I do have the dye up to temperature. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and sit this in the dye. I unplugged my immersion heater just because I don't trust it in here. I don't want to get shocked or anything. So what I'm going to do is just let that sit in there. I don't know, it's steaming. I don't know if you can see that on the camera or not. It's at 140 degrees, so the immersion heater did seem to work. One thing I noticed is that the thermostat on the heater was very hot. So it's from Amazon, it's cheap. I don't know how long it's going to last, but anyway, we'll come back here in a few minutes and we'll just kind of see if it's going to take the collar or not. See if this is a failed experiment or if it actually works. All right, so here is the part after it has been anodized. It has not been sealed. So I'm calling this a success. There is some blotchy spots. And if you look closely, that looks like fingerprints. So I'm thinking maybe when I was handling it, after pulling it out of the acid bath without gloves before I put it in the dye, I'm thinking that might have caused it. I'm not sure yet. I will do some research. But overall, you know, for my first attempt, it is pretty good. We were able to anodize a part. And again, there's another little blotchy spot. So there are some kinks to work out in the process. But overall, I think it is doable. So what I'm going to do now is just go ahead and put this in boiling water and seal it. And, you know, then we'll go ahead and see if we can't do this base a little better.